We're here in chilly and Dickens Springs, Colorado, where the air is thin and the smoke is thick. It's Pop Brownie Day here at sold-out No Authority Field. And the crowd is fired up for some football after an intense pregame screening of 2001 A Space Odyssey. Today's matchup features the two teams who survived the regular season and playoffs. Tonight, they go to war in the mayhem.
The San Francisco 49ers battle
the Yorks of Hazard. Here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and see what the team captains had to say.
Okay.
And welcome to the NFL Mayhem Bowl. Grim Blitro with you here along with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr.
Hi, everyone. I can't wait for the commercials to start. That's always my favorite part.
We've got the biggest game of the year here, Bricks. Two teams battling each other in the ultimate battle of death.
Yeah, but those butt wiper beer commercials with the horses, they make me want to cry, Grim.
That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And then clears it. Oh, he took a leap and had the ball knocked out. Fumble.
He's got a case of fumble-itis.
Second down and nine.
Hot one, hot two.
And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him. Should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Second and eight to go.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have to meet at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with
first and 10. Second down and 6.
Well, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game.
Oh, could it be mine?
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
It's 2 yard run before he stopped. And that'll be second and 8 to go. Run for 5 yards. Third down and 3.
Hot one, hot two.
And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. And it's first and 10. The 2 minute warning, folks. Stay tuned from a halftime show. And it's first and 10. Tired of the quarterback's tight spirals and magnetic personality. And in some leagues, you aren't even allowed to touch the QB. In the NFL, they have plays just for killing them. That's what I'm talking about. First and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And they stump the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move here. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point in the game. Nice and easy, like a 2 foot putt.
You miss 2 foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they own my stuff up. That was just a one time thing.
First and 10. And the defense gives up 5 yards there. And they take their first timeout.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
Second down and 5. Says, who's next? Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Ha! And how about a little dirt sandwich? first and 10. Football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Then why is it that long men like the Stan Clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
Now they're all in politics, apparently. 2nd and 3. Some clock by calling a timeout. They have one left. And it's 1st and 10. Satan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify.
That little doggy found his way home because of that butt wiper beer horse.
And Fricks for live now. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Mayhem Bowl. Seems like the commercials are taking their toll on Bricks here.
It was so touchy, Griff. He found his way back.
Here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. The brutal hit. cc's of adrenaline. And it's first and 10. And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And that's another turnover for the defense. Second down and 7. Third down and the punter is warming up. Range. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from top.
Does anyone have a rule book? Because that sounds like he's making stuff up.
Do we have a rule book?
It's propping up your chair so you can reach the table without spilling your food, idiot.
Jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Now here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. The third quarter mercifully ends. If this game is as painful to watch as we are to listen to, then please accept our apologies. This one is just about over.
I got the thing stuck in my ear again.
Signals a hurry up.
Yeah, see, that Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
She called it.
And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. Calls their first timeout.
Oh, thank God! I've been sitting on this burrito for the last 2 hours. I gotta go.
Thanks, Bricks. Really appreciate that transparency. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Oh, man, he just crushed him. I gotta see that again.
I hit a kid once like that, walking down the sidewalk, texting with his earbuds in, freaked him out. He said, hey, what'd you do that for? I said, I teach you a lesson. What lesson, he said? That unless you're a baboon with big baboon balls, you gotta pay attention. Yeah, law of the jungle, you know?
A pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down and 7. And the 2-minute warning sound.
Sounds like what, Grim?
Sounds like the asshole I'm living on.
Second down and 7. Well, the offense is pretty much unstoppable. And he fumbles it, Bricks. That was a screwed up play if I ever saw one. He broke free and has open field in front of him. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. And he runs it in for the touchdown. Some fine footwork right there. Oh, man. Point attempt. It's good. The onside kick is a desperation play, but it's their only chance at this point to steal possession.
Still, it ain't right, Glenn. It just ain't right.
Talk about kickers when they win or lose games. This guy just earned his paycheck.
Which is typically the amount the quarterback tips on dinner.
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage.
Oh, this berserk dirty trick ain't fair.
Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
Oh, this is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
Rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
And that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. He refuses to go down. Oh, he probably thought it was an earthquake. I bet he wishes he was right. In between being digested, that is. They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
The offense has an uphill battle, and it all starts with making this first down.
You have to admire that fighting spirit. It's stupid, but you still have to admire it.
This play had no chance. This baby is over, and the fat lady is singing.
Yeah, speaking of fat, once I decide to burn some calories, so I set a fat kid on fire.
The ball razors through the defense, cutting a defender in half.
That means they can wrap up the other half and save it for later.
And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And defense burns its last timeout. You can't take them into the locker room, so you might as well use them now.
Why would you want to take a timeout into the locker room, Grim? That doesn't sound right.
Just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
The Orcs of Hazzard suffer a loss today. In a game that certainly didn't live up to the hype but was entertaining. If you like lopsided wins, we're crowning a new Mayhem Bowl champion today.
I had a lopsided girlfriend once. She was a strange one.
Well, I was with you. That kind of says it all, right?
On to the Mayhem Bowl MVP. Once again, the folks at Evil Sam thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League. Sarah Ken Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off. And that's a wrap. All right, that's another season, boys. Good job. Hey, Bricks, put the cheerleaders in, huh? Hey, Junior, start rolling.
On it, boss.
I love you guys. We got the best gig in the world.
Hey, stow it, dipshit. Start filling the hot tub. Hey, where's the champagne?
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so you...